Thank you very much, Chris, and welcome everyone to Talk of the Town for this Thursday. I'm Steve Noxon, and as we do the third Thursday, I think, of every month, we are joined by Lynn Ward, and we'll talk about all things Waterbury Regional Chamber. Hi, Lynn.
Hey, good morning, Steve. How are you?
Doing well, you?
I'm great.
It's just you and I here for a while.
Yeah, for a little while, and then we're going to have a guest come in a little while, but yeah, happy to have, you know, the opportunity to talk about what's been going on at our chamber, all of our chambers.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a great time of year.
We had
our holiday gathering last night at La Bella Vista.
Saw the pictures on Facebook. It looked like you had a blast. Santa was there with Mrs. Claus.
Yeah, we had a great time. We had a little over 200 people attend at La Bella Vista, which, you know, is a beautiful facility. Mm-hmm. They do a fantastic job. The food was delicious, and the room and the whole atmosphere was very festive. So I want to give a great shout out to Andrew and his team at La Bella Vista, because the chamber was happy to be there last night. And of course, to our members who came. That's a members only event, and it's supported by our board of directors. So our board members, you know, when we invite people to join our board, I tell them three things. You have to be supportive and encouraging of membership in our chamber. You have to come to as many board meetings as you can. And you have to support the holiday gathering.
Of course.
So that's a financial commitment. And that's just part of being a board member. So our board was very happy to support us. And it was a great event.
Sounds good. And this is one of a number of events that you're having, right?
Last week we had for our new Southbury Chamber of Commerce. And in Southbury, if you have a business in Southbury and you want to join our chamber, you would be designated as a member of the Southbury Chamber, but you get all the benefits of the Waterbury Regional Chamber. So it really is two chambers in one. And we had our first very large event. It included the community as well as the business community. And that was called the Festival of REITs.
Right.
And Chatfield's True Value and Onyx Fine Jewelers and Ion Bank were our large sponsors, our lead sponsors. A whole host of companies supported this event. And we had 58 REITs that were decorated by local companies. And when people came and were able to network, have a pasta dinner, and really get into the festive spirit, they were able to buy raffle tickets to win a wreath. So 58 people were very happy go home with a wreath, and we had a great...
And 142 went home disappointed.
No, at that event, because we did have close to 200 people at that event, too. All the things that the chamber has been doing, you know, on the event side have been very well received. Our goal is to promote local businesses. So whether we do that through our social media efforts, which I encourage everyone to please follow the chamber on Facebook, on Instagram, on LinkedIn, so that you can really, you know, you may not be a business owner, you may be retired, and it's a great way to stay informed of what the local business community is doing.
Well, you and I were talking about that in the lobby before we came on the air about mm-hmm. how much I've learned in doing the show with you here about the value that you bring to your members. You know, it's not just these networking events, which are nice. It's the services that you're offering and the education and the mm-hmm. The legal, not legal services, but certainly legal advice when all of these changes that are constantly coming at these
right.
businesses. I don't know how a small business keeps up.
Yeah, it is definitely a challenge, and our challenge to maintain and grow our business. You know, the Chamber of Commerce is a business also. We are a pretty large industry. If you think about chambers across the country, across the world, there is a Chamber of Commerce in every city in the world. So this is its own industry, and the challenge for us is on the education side. People don't understand what the chamber does mm-hmm. and how we can help their businesses. And, you know, the people who've been in business for many years are the hardest ones to encourage to join us, because they'll say, I've been doing business without the chamber. I don't need the chamber.
Right.
And, you know, we, of course, we have talking points to that. And I love to have those conversations, and I love to have the opportunity to talk to people who may feel that way, because it doesn't matter if you've been in business, you know, for 5 days or 50 years. There's so much that we can do to help support the businesses. And a lot of times people just, they don't know what they don't know. And right. That's the scary part. So if you're not getting some guidance on all sorts of issues, whether it's public policy, which right now we are formulating our legislative agenda with, you know, great input from the business community and what we should be advocating for in this upcoming session, you know, there can be HR issues that we can help you with. A lot of marketing, you know, I hear from manufacturers all the time that I don't sell any of my products here. There's nothing you can do for me. And I love to have those conversations, because I'll talk to you about workforce. I'll talk to you about public policy. Right. I'll talk to you about HR and labor issues, and all which have nothing to do with where your product is being sold right. or shipped to.
Yeah, it is so comprehensive. And again, it's, that's one of the things that I think I've really enjoyed over the last, you know, 5+ years that we've been doing this, is learning so much about what the chamber offers. And I've really been surprised in a lot of different areas. Mm-hmm. And, you know, so I've become, you know, kind of going from sort of, you know, ambivalent about whatever a chamber is to being a real advocate for it.
Yeah.
Maybe not as successfully, but some of this I'd hope to be, but I am out there talking you up every chance
I
get.
Yeah, so. Well, thank you, Steve. It's definitely helpful. And we just want people to understand. And, you know, sometimes people who have been in business just want to be part of an organization. Mm-hmm. So, you know, and there's the old saying too, like, just do the right thing, support your community through your Chamber of Commerce. You know, that we like to talk about the tangible things, and there's plenty. So I encourage people to call me directly. Yeah. I'd love to have the conversation.
And the chamber supports the community as well. You're a part of so many things that go on here
yes.
in and around Waterbury too. So
you we know, are
it's kind of a symbiotic relationship, I guess is the right term for it.
Well, just last week, the Main Street Waterbury organization that now the chamber is really taking the lead role on administrating with the Main Street Waterbury program, we did the downtown stroll. So when you think about, you know, the chamber now getting involved in strictly community events, mm-hmm. certainly supporting the downtown businesses was the key focus there. But we had a good time bringing people down and showing them the different organizations and shops that are downtown Waterbury.
Sometimes it just takes a little motivation to get people out there.
Exactly.
So you got a couple of cool things coming up next year too that we want to talk about. But the first one I'd like to touch on is the Business Women's Forum, only because in just a week or so is the early pricing is going to end,
right.
correct?
Yes. So the Business Women's Forum is an event that we have done for 40 years. This is the 40th
wow.
annual conference. And it's amazing to me that I've been around for 38 of those. They all kind of blend together, but we're really looking forward to this year's event on March 15th at the AquaTurf. And we have Rebecca Minkoff. She is our keynote speaker. She is world renowned. She's a fashion designer. She's an author. And she will be coming here in person on March 15th. So we do have, if you go to ctbwf.com, you can check out what the rest of the program is going to look like. And there's a discount on early bird pricing that is going to expire on December 31st. So we encourage people to check out the Business Women's Forum. And if you have a business, or if you are the marketing director of a business and your goal is to market to women, which we know 80% of all purchasing decisions are made by women. No matter how much, Steve, you think you have some say,
I have none.
Your wife is really calling the shots.
Oh, no, I know that for sure. Learned that lesson a long time ago.
So we want companies to think about sponsoring the Business Women's Forum, because this is a great market, and certainly it helps support the organization. It's a scholarship-based organization, so every year we give scholarships to students at Post University who are studying in business courses. So hundreds of thousands of dollars has been given away over the past 40 years, awesome. 39 years, and now coming up to the 40th from the Businesswoman's Forum.
What else would you like to promote? You got a whole list of things
here
for next
year. Yeah, we
have
a lot going on. I want to give a shout out to Holy Cross High School because January 25th, we're going to have our Out for Business at Holy Cross. And this is a great opportunity for chamber members to network with one another. And also an opportunity that if you've been thinking about joining the chamber and, you know, the new year is coming, lots of, we're going to, oh, you know, we all hear all the resolutions. I'm the first one, very guilty, going to lose weight again, right? So, but for business people, I'm hearing that they said, in fact, I was at a little business in Prospect yesterday, and I said, you know, you haven't come to anything. We need to get you out. And she said, my resolution January 1 for the new year is to start coming to chamber events and networking because I need to increase my business. So whether you are a member or you're not yet a member, but you've been thinking about it, this event, we would welcome non-members to register as a guest and you can join us. So that's January 25th and you can go on waterburychamber.com. If you're not yet a member, please give us a call and you can ask to be put on the list to join us that evening. We're also doing a job fair. So many companies are hiring. This will be the fourth job fair in the last 18 months that we're having. And this will be on February 1st at the Courtyard Marriott. We've been doing all of our job fairs at the Courtyard. And we've had you, Steve, come and do remotes from there.
Spoken to a lot of people there. It's really interesting to speak to a lot of these different business owners and kind of learn what they're looking for. You know, as far as, you know, staffing and workforce and, but there's also, the other thing that I find cool about it is it's not just businesses looking for people. There's also, organizations that you bring in to help people get jobs mm-hmm. and to help people improve their skill sets. So it's more than just your basic jobs fair. It's actually more of a, again, education, as you mentioned earlier, it's offering these additional, skill sets. You know, for people to learn the soft skills and maybe some manufacturing programs that mm-hmm. show up there. So it really is. It encompasses everything basically to do with jobs.
Yes. And we do our job fairs with the Northwest Regional Workforce Investment Board mm-hmm. and the Workforce Board here in Waterbury that serves, I think, the whole western side of the state or within this immediate region. They have numerous programs that can help people who might be looking to become skilled in a different type of job, or they just need that hand up to, you know, to get some more support that they're not able to get on their own. So we encourage people to go to the Workforce Board's website, come to the chamber, and we can help you learn more about what they have to offer.
You've also got an event coming up, and I think you should probably mention it now because you're trying to get sponsorship for this event, and you won't be back until after this date passes, that January 10th, and that's the Malcolm Baldrige Chamber Awards.
It is. So tomorrow we are going to be meeting with our executive committee. That is the selection committee for the Malcolm Baldrige Community Award. And the Malcolm Baldrige Community Award is a very prestigious award given by our Waterbury Regional Chamber. We are the only chamber in the country that can give an award out in Malcolm Baldrige's name. You know, Mac Baldrige was Secretary of Commerce under President Ronald Reagan. And before he went to Washington, he was a business leader here. He was a member of our board of directors. Mm. And when he passed, we approached Midge Baldrige and their daughters and talked to them about being able to create an award in Mac's name. And they certainly welcomed us to do that. And we've been doing that, giving this award out for more than 20 years now. So we will be announcing this year's Malcolm Baldrige Award winner very soon. And we will also announce the Leader of the Year and the Volunteer of the Year. Those are people that have directly impacted our Waterbury Regional Chamber. So three awards given that night, and that's going to be in February It's
February 23rd.
February 23rd. Yep. Yes. Thanks for helping me with that date. Yeah, there's so much going on. In January for our Naugatuck Chamber, you know, so I've mentioned the Southbury Chamber. Also, we have the Watertown Oakville Chamber, and we have the Naugatuck Chamber. And on January 19th, Chet Doheny, who is an incredible business owner. Chet has several businesses in and around the Naugatuck area. He's going to be receiving our Lewis A. Dibble Award, which is a very prestigious award in Naugatuck. And the Naugatuck Chamber has been presenting that award for quite some time. So this is going to be at our 101st annual meeting on January 19th. So a lot going on. Yeah.
A lot going on. And finally, before we take a break and invite your guests in here, I want to give you a chance to promote one last thing, and that is your trip.
Yes. So we have been talking about the Chamber Travel Program on WATR over the years. And I know, Steve, you're aware, we just came back from Amalfi with our chamber. We had 65 people go to Amalfi, and it was a wonderful time. And the benefit of traveling with the chamber is that everything is taken care of for you, right from getting on a bus in Waterbury, getting to JFK, getting to wherever our destination is, and all your time there, everything is mapped out for you. You don't have to make any decisions other than maybe where you want to go to dinner on your free night. So we've had great success with our travel program, and we have decided that next October the trip is going to be to Greece. Nice. This is called Land of the Gods and Heroes. So we do have some information on our website. Most of the people that go on these trips are people from the community. They may be retired, you know, or not. We have some chamber members go. The majority of people are not members of the chamber, which gives us an opportunity to connect, you know, with them, mm-hmm. and have them experience the chamber in a different way, right. in a different program.
It's not all about business. It can be fun sometimes.
Not always, yeah. right. But this is the company that we use for these trips, very reputable company. It's called Aventura World. And this is a fundraiser for the chamber, too. So Aventura pays the chamber to, you know, do what we do to get people to go. So it's a great opportunity to support your local chamber and go on a vacation that everything is taken care of.
And so, everybody needs a vacation.
Yeah. So go to waterburychamber.com. You can read more about that. And we already know in 2024, we're going to be going to Croatia.
Cool.
Yeah, I just came back from there.
I envy you. Check things
out, and it's beautiful. If you've gone to Italy or ever wanted to go to Italy, I would say Croatia is very similar, and wonderful people over there, beautiful sights, and the food is really good too.
Well, that's good to know. We, like I told you earlier, my wife and I had planned to go. We had been talking about it for a couple of months, and we were just about to pull the trigger and buy the tickets and get everything done around February of 2020.
Bad timing.
Yeah, we were actually on a walk, and I said, and we were talking about, okay, I'll get in touch with the travel agent. I said, you know, let's just hold off a week or two and see how this whole COVID thing works out.
Yeah.
And as we saw,
right,
we went to the Brantford coast for our vacation that year instead of Croatia. But yeah, and it's someplace. It's like it's kind of on our wish list, our to-do list here to get there. So I envy you. So
well, you know,
maybe
you can start planning.
Yeah, we'll start
for 2023 or 2024.
Putting our nickels and dimes aside, and who knows, maybe we can kind of make that happen. Well, Lynn, I want to take a break now because I know your guests are out in the lobby, and we want to bring them in. And so we're talking all things chamber here on Talk of the Town. We'll be back with more right after these words.
Time now for an eloquent remembrance of Christmas past. A heartwarming holiday snapshot in sound. As we turn another page in the family Christmas album.
WATR's Holiday Memories, brought to you by Thomaston Savings Bank, rated by Forbes magazine as Connecticut's top in-state bank and the top community bank in the country.
Thomaston Savings Bank has been ranked by Forbes as the best bank in the country based on customer satisfaction, digital services, financial advice, branch services, and trustworthiness. Come see why you get more when you're next door. Visit thomastonsb.com/Forbes. Thomaston Savings Bank, member FDIC.
Well, my mother and father live out in Arvin, California, which is by Los Angeles. And one year, we took the kids and we rode an Amtrak train out. And, oh, it was beautiful. And it was snowing and the snow out on the plains and the mountains. And we went through a couple tunnels. And it was really great. We had a wonderful old-fashioned Christmas out there. It was the first Christmas we've spent with them in 20 years. And it was great. We got to see all the relatives and the friends. And on Christmas Day, my brothers were there and my mom and dad. And she had a beautiful tree and her house was decorated really pretty, and she had had the church made homemade quilts for all the kids in the family, and it was just really nice. Everyone had a keepsake to take home with them, a quilt. And then we rode the train back, and it was cold when we got here. Out in California there was oranges on the trees and lemons, and I could walk around barefooted, and we come back to like 2 foot of snow. It was yeah, what a shock.
Holiday memories brought to you here on WATR by Thomason Savings Bank.
Are you 50 or over and looking to expand your horizons? Become a lifelong learner. Join OLLI, the OSHA Lifelong Learning Institute at UConn Waterbury. If you're interested in history, painting, music, current events, and much more, OLLI has the affordable learning experiences you've been looking for. There are no tests and no homework. Our members say OLLI is the best program in Waterbury for seniors, and we agree. Call 203-236-9924 or visit olli.ucon.edu. It's time to do something for you. It's time to join OLLI. Call 203-236-9924 or visit olli.ucon.edu. OLLI at UConn, where learning never retires.
After 88 years, WATR remains the only place to get the headlines, updates, and breaking news from around Greater Waterbury. This is News Director Chris Fortier. Each weekday morning and midday, we bring you live and hyper-local news from the Brass City and beyond, with regional traffic and the weather forecast from News 8 Chief Meteorologist Gil Simmons. So stay tuned as we keep you in touch live from the studios of WATR AM 1320 and FM 97.7.
Here's News 8 Chief Meteorologist Gil Simmons with a look at our weather.
All righty, Steve, I'm watching this precipitation shield advance in our direction. We have quite a mess on the way for tonight and tomorrow. Low elevations, not much snow, but higher elevations, there is going to be an accumulation of wet snow. Our local WATR forecast, that mix developing and moving in later on today, going into and through the evening, and it may go back and forth, starting as rain, going over to some wet snow, then back to some rain, and sort of back to some wet snow. Coating the 3 inches from downtown Waterbury to the higher elevations here around Waterbury. But as you go up Route 8, 6 inches or more expected, especially Torrington, up to the highest elevations in northwestern Connecticut. 30s tonight into tomorrow. This will be ending late tomorrow night. Dry weather Saturday and Sunday. Another storm at the end of next week. For WATR News 8, Chief Meteorologist Gil Simmons, have a great afternoon.
36 degrees and cloudy here in Waterbury at 10:34. Back to Talk of the Town. I'm Steve Noxon, and again, we are joined by Ms. Lynn Ward from the Waterbury Regional Chamber, and she has brought in some special guests.
I did. So we have in the studio two beautiful women who are with one chamber member that's actually representative of three different companies. So it's almost like we have three different members here all within one, one or two people. And I want to welcome Rachel Yimoyines, who is one of the owners of the shops at Middlebury, Vyne Restaurant, and the new Brewbury Brewery. So three chamber members, all represented by the same family. Thank you, Rachel, for coming in today to talk about everything that's going on within the
The
whole suite of businesses that you have.
Exactly. We're happy to be here and talk a little bit about what we're doing at each of these businesses.
Thank you. And Kendall, please introduce yourself. So Kendall is...
Oh, well, lovely to be here. I'm the director of events at Vyne, and I also coordinate with the new brewery and work very closely with the family over at the shops. I don't do any work at the shops, but we see them every day, and we're constantly creating new and exciting events for the area.
Well, thank you both for coming in and joining me. You know, during the holiday season, we have been promoting to our members and the general public, you know, on this show, in our Republican American column, on our social media, we're encouraging everybody to shop local. I know it's really easy to sit at home and press some buttons and have things show up at your door. However, it's a lot of fun to go out and support the local companies that are here in our region. And I wanted to, you know, do a little bit of a review about what are the shops all about. And I know I've been there. I enjoy shopping there. I love the product lines that you have. But can we talk a little bit about that?
Sure. Well, every day people are so surprised when they walk in and they haven't been in, or it's been a few years since they've been in. So the furniture, the Middlebury Furniture and Home Design, is at the 1101 Southford Road location in Middlebury. And we moved the gift shop to the front of the furniture store. And so it's really kind of a wonderful shopping experience, whether you're looking for furniture and you hit the gift shop, or you're just coming in quickly to buy a gift. But we have just something for everyone in the gift shop. Just some great lines, unique lines that you really can't find anywhere else. We kind of strive to get things that you don't see in every gift shop around. So we have Mackenzie Childs, and really excited, we just brought Simon Pierce back in, which their Christmas trees are just so beautiful. We have ornaments for everybody at every price point. And then we have some of your local chocolatiers like Fascia's and Bridgewater. So if you're running to somebody's home and you need to grab a box of chocolates, we have that available. We have women's accessories and scarves, mud pie, Julie Voss jewelry, John Madero's jewelry, some great quality lines of jewelry. So there's really something for everybody. And the best part is people are also really happily surprised that we do gift wrap, and mm-hmm. we do it for free. And it's hard to even get a box anywhere now. So we have some beautiful boxes and we ribbon it. So it's, you just go home and put it under the tree.
That's very convenient. I was in a store the other day, which I will not mention, when they told me that the box was $2.50. I said, what? Yeah. Well, it's a fundraiser for something. I'm like, yeah, no, thanks.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that's great.
Boxes and bags are free.
Yeah. And you also have a great line for, or various lines, but all displayed for like men's gifts. Because sometimes it's hard to find men's gifts.
It's very hard. It's hard to find nice men's gifts and nice baby gifts. So we've really focused the past year or so on really expanding those two areas, and just some quality men's hats and scarves, and a lot of golfers in the area. So we have a lot of golf kind of funny gifts, and also with so many lakes in the area, that some great gifts for people who live, you know, on or around lakes. But yeah, we've been expanding the men's line, so you could definitely find something for you know, your father, your husband, on, you know, in our shop. And then with the baby line, we brought in some great quality clothing lines, Angel Deer, Milk Barn. It's, you know, organic cotton, super soft. And then, of course, my favorite, Jelly Cat, which is our super plush with stuffed animals that come with
them. I love those. Yeah. I love walking in and seeing those. They're so cute.
Yeah. And it's just an easy, good quality gift to give somebody who just had a baby or a shower. And I think those kind of gifts, it's just hard to find locally. Mm-hmm.
Yes, and you must have little helpers at home. I know you are a mom of some beautiful little girls, so they must tell you, you know, what you should have next in the store.
Yes, and I try and have them not take every stuffed animal they like out of the store, because one of them is a lover of bunnies, so every little stuffed bunny she sees, she wants to put in her pocket and take home. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, it's probably like their playground.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. It's a great shop. Tell us again the address.
It's 1101 Southford Road in Middlebury. And it's the old, some people recognize the old trucking museum that was there, right by Pomparog High School, right off exit 16 is the easiest, most direct way to get there.
Well, and right down the street is Vyne Restaurant, right?
2 miles.
So beautiful. Also in your suite of companies.
Yeah.
Kendall, you want to talk a little bit about Vyne?
Oh, of course.
What's been going on there?
Oh, yes. Well, I was, you know, funny. I came about Vyne. I lived in New York City for 15 years, and I worked in many high-end restaurants there. And when we moved to Connecticut, was, you know, just looking, you know, trying to find a place similar to my experience. And when I saw Vyne, it was 2020, and they weren't hiring. And I'll tell you, I was so taken by the building, by the architecture, by the food. And I was like, I will work here. I'm going to work here. And then now I do.
Good for you.
Because I
love that story.
Had a vision. I said, I'm going to be there. Vyne is incredible. I think it is, especially coming from New York, I've been able to see some really outstanding restaurants, not just the food, but also the decor and the architecture. And so, you know, just the fact that I was so taken with Vyne, I feel so lucky that that's where I get to go every day. But what makes Vyne really unique is it is an events venue and a restaurant combined. It's four levels, three of which are event spaces of various sizes. We can accommodate, you know, really intimate gatherings of even just 10 people. We're having just 12 people for 50th birthday next week. We have our Whittemore Ballroom, which opens up over these bridges and waterfalls to these gorgeous gardens, can accommodate up to about 200 people. And what sets us apart is the fact that we have this award-winning restaurant on the second floor, and our executive chef, who's, you know, this gregarious, amazing man, but also an incredibly talented chef, Phil Pizzella, he oversees both. So you're really getting restaurant-style quality food at your events, and that's something that just separates us from other venues. And it's this elegant, modern, kind of understated elegance with the architecture. And we have, I think, come out of COVID, and we're just bursting at this point. People are really excited and wanting to party again, and we're here for that.
And Kendall does a lot of the tours, and it's funny because she says what really sells people at the end and gets them to want to have it here is when she shows them the brewery next door.
That she could not be more. That is so true. So, you know, there was so much intrigue last winter as we were building the brewery. So the brewery, now for me, this is such an easy sell for especially weddings. These brides and grooms are interested in having an event at Vyne. But specifically when it comes to weddings, you know, you show them the whole space. And then I say, but who wants the party to end? It's your wedding day. You still want to have fun. You know, it's just because the bell strikes 10 or whatever doesn't mean it's over. Let's walk truly 10 steps across the parking lot to this incredibly vibrant and different space where we brew our own beer, but it's also a fully stocked bar. So someone like me, who I like beer, but it's not my go-to, I can still get my wine, and you know, my husband can have his beer. And it's been a really wonderful combination for weddings and then after parties. It's kind of just meant to be.
Well, it sounds like a lot of great activities going on. I need to go over there and see Brewbury. I've heard all about it.
Come on Tuesday for trivia night. I am the reigning champion, just saying.
You are, really?
She did win this week.
I did win this week.
Okay.
Good for you.
That's a challenge here.
So, Steve, are you a beer drinker?
I've been known to throw back a beer, too.
Okay, yeah. Well,
and
you know.
And also, I'm pretty good at trivia.
Oh, you must come. It's great.
I've participated in 3 trivia contests, and I've won 2 of them.
Wow.
So. Okay. Oh, well, I will take that challenge.
Okay. as long as it's not about sports.
I know, I'm with you.
No, we're good. We can go right up to the top.
So, Rachel, can we talk a little bit about the next venture?
We can. Okay. So, you know, very exciting. We hope in the very near future we will be opening up the winery in Middlebury, right on Lake Quassapaug, Tranquility Vineyard. Right now, we currently have quite a few vines planted, and we'll start making wine 2023. So, and Kendall has done some really amazing Walk with the Winemaker tours there, where our winemaker takes people through the vines and explains all the different kinds of grapes we have planted. It's a beautiful location, and hopefully also possibly a new location for events.
Wow. Well, we're doing events, kind of teaser events right now. We were able to do in the fall of just giving a preview of what's to come. There's 16,000 vines. They just finished planting with this beautiful barn space, ability to have, you know, an outdoor tent. So the location is stunning. And we're very fortunate because the winemaker who we've been working with is very accomplished. And so you get not just the location, but really outstanding quality wine.
And we also have a, this year they put a garden up, which
Vegetable garden.
Yeah,
yes.
Which Vyne used for a lot of the vegetables this summer.
Yes, we were able to do farm to table specials at Vyne from the vegetables grown right on location.
Yep. Wow.
So that was great.
Yeah.
Cool.
Well, you said 16,000 vines. And as soon as you said that, I thought about the flowers that I plant, you know, around my house. Which may be like 50.
Yeah. Yes.
Could you imagine planting 16,000 of anything?
Yes. Yeah, there's a crew there.
Oh,
all
my
the time.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. That's an incredible amount of work.
Yeah.
And so all this is done. So we're talking about the shops at Middlebury, the furniture and gift shop, Vyne Restaurant and Event Center, Brewbury. And now we're talking about a winery. And this is all conceived and led and done by how many family members?
Well, I mean, you know, my father-in-law, Dean, is really the brains of the operation here.
It's true.
So he is really the idea person and pushes through all these new businesses. And Linda, his wife, works mostly, you can find her down at the shops.
I've never been at the shops and not seen Linda.
Yeah.
I don't care what time of day it is, what day of the week it is.
True.
She's there.
She's always there. Yeah.
So it's Dean and Linda.
Yeah.
And your husband, Dean Jr.
My husband, Dean Jr., Dean John, and he runs the furniture store. So both the new and consigned. So you'll find him all 6 days down at Middlebury Furniture and Home Design. And that's where he is. And then I float in a couple different places. Back and forth, and we all kind of take part in, you know, running the businesses.
That's amazing. So, Steve, can you imagine that the scope and size of these businesses are really led by four people?
It's incredible.
Right? Amazing.
Incredible.
Amazing family.
I don't know where you
and
find the time.
Amazing vision.
Mm-hmm.
And the economic development and the economic return to our area, you know, specifically we're talking about in Middlebury, is really phenomenal.
Mm-hmm.
And I hope people pay attention to that and realize that, because, you know, there's a lot of great entrepreneurship going on here, a lot of great investment. And you might, I'll say, just be a beer drinker. You might be somebody who likes fine dining. You might be somebody like me who likes to shop. and pretty soon you might be somebody who, you know, enjoys wine, and you can get all of that and so much more working or experiencing one of or all of these businesses, all led
and
by the same
family. And it's all actually within, what, a mile and a half, 2 miles?
Within 2 miles.
All of them are, yeah.
No, it's I've been there, I think, once. I've been to the shops. And it's just, it's amazing. Like you say, you find so many things there that you just wouldn't find elsewhere. It gives you great ideas. And I think that's probably one of the biggest things for most people, especially myself, as I was telling you earlier.
Yeah, December's, you have some shopping to do.
December's a tough month for me.
Yeah.
and I, you know, after a while, you run out of ideas.
Yeah.
Well, we are open on Christmas Eve for all those, you know, husbands or men who are last minute looking for gifts.
Yes, when you look under the tree and you see 15 boxes with your name on
beautifully wrapped with a perfect bow, you know you went to the shop.
Well, I think you should go to Middlebury and do a little bit of shopping.
I'm writing it down here.
Yeah.
I don't know if you noticed, I've been taking copious notes. But yeah, I think that is probably the best aspect of this, is it is unique. And it does kind of get the creative juices flowing. It does give you some ideas that maybe, you know, you wouldn't think of. And again, I'll just say for myself, I'm horrible when it comes to ideas. I mean, a gift card, that's, you know, here. But no, places like yours and restaurants like yours are just wonderful locations. And I think, and you're right, it really does bring something special to the community as
well. Yes, absolutely.
And we hear it every day, which kind of makes what we do, you know, all worth it, is people have been so... We're so glad you're here. We're so glad when we opened Brewbury. Oh, we needed something like this in town. So it's always great to hear the support from local
And it
residents.
Fits the community real well, too. I think that's a nice part of it. It really just kind of fits right in with that whole kind of Brewbury feel, you know?
Yeah.
Well, and if you need help while you're shopping, the women and men down at the shops are very helpful. So
All right.
Yeah. Definitely. Well, thank you for coming in today.
Yes. Oh, our pleasure.
Thank you for having us.
Absolutely. Nice meeting both of you, and continued success.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Vineyard.
Yes.
And we'll take a break and come back and talk about a few more things you've got on the agenda for next year. You were talking about the Waterbury Regional Chamber here on Talk of the Town. We'll be back after these words.
What's the best product I bought this year? Oh, that's easy. Salonpas pain-relieving patches. The proven medicines in Salonpas patches reduce my pain and let me do the things I need to do every day.
In a recent clinical study, patients using Salonpas reported improved sleep, mood, and the ability to work. They had less pain and were able to reduce their use of oral pain medications.
For pain, I use Salonpas. It's good medicine. He sent me to...
At Waterbury Health, we urge you, don't put your health on hold. It's safe, we are ready, and we want you to come.
This is Ehsan Ansari, a cardiologist at Waterbury Hospital. Today I'm speaking about aortic valve stenosis, which is a narrowing of the aortic valve. This is a fairly common degenerative disease of cardiac valves. As we age, we become more at risk of developing aortic valve stenosis. At Waterbury Hospital Heart and Valve Center, we started performing transcatheter aortic valve replacement, which is a minimally invasive procedure in a safe perform in patients that are not candidate for the traditional open heart surgery. The advantage of this transcatheter valve replacement is that these patients can go home within 24 to 48 hours with less complication after the procedure and back to a normal life within a week. For more information, call the Heart and Valve Center at Waterbury Hospital at 203-573-7264.
Waterbury Health affiliates include Waterbury Hospital, Alliance Medical Group, Cardiology Associates of Greater Waterbury, Access Rehab Centers, Greater Waterbury Imaging Center, and VNA Health at Home. For more information, visit WTBYHealth.org. This week on WATR, it's a unique UConn Husky schedule. This Saturday the 17th, it's UConn men's basketball at Butler at 6:30 p.m. But on Monday, it's UConn football versus Marshall at the Myrtle Beach Bowl. And that starts at 1 o'clock Monday afternoon. On Tuesday the 20th, we're back to basketball with UConn men versus Georgetown at 6 p.m. All brought to you in part by the Savings Bank of Danbury, the law offices of Julie Porcio, and Thomaston Savings Bank. On WATR 1320 AM, FM 97.7, and streaming live.
Here's News 8 Chief Meteorologist Gil Simmons with another check on our weather.
All righty, Steve, I'm watching this precipitation shield advance in our direction. We have quite a mess on the way for tonight and tomorrow. Low elevations, not much snow, but higher elevations, there is going to be an accumulation of wet snow. Our local WATR forecast, that mix developing and moving in later on today, going into and through the evening, and it may go back and forth, starting as rain, going over to some wet snow, then back to some rain, and sort of back to some wet snow. Coating the 3 inches from downtown Waterbury to the higher elevations here around Waterbury. But as you go up Route 8, 6 inches or more expected, especially Torrington, up to the highest elevations in northwestern Connecticut. 30s tonight into tomorrow. This will be ending late tomorrow night. Dry weather Saturday and Sunday. Another storm at the end of next week. For WATR News 8, Chief Meteorologist Gil Simmons, have a great afternoon.
36 degrees and cloudy here in Waterbury at 10:55. Welcome back to Talk of the Town. I am Steve Noxon and Lynn. Good guests.
Yes. Yes. We've been talking about shopping during this holiday season, and we were specifically talking about some Middlebury resources. Of course, at the Waterbury Regional Chamber, we represent 14 towns, and there are wonderful shops in all of our towns. Mm-hmm. The Brass Mill Center Mall has some great things going on there, and we're going to be having the mall manager on and one of our future shows to talk about some new things, new businesses that are coming into our mall. So certainly want to give a shout out to them and encourage people to go there, shop. Check out all the small boutiques and shops throughout the greater Waterbury region. You can go to waterburychamber.com and you could search retail, see what companies, what businesses are members of the chamber. With our new Southbury Chamber now, we have quite a bit of small boutique style members in the Southbury area. So encourage you to shop local, go to waterburychamber.com and, you know, support the businesses that are supporting the business community.
I think it actually means a little bit more too when you actually go out there and you look through what's available and you kind of pick out something special, you know. And again, I was talking about seriously getting ideas when you go out shopping as opposed to just scrolling
right
on a website. I mean, it's just there's something extra behind that gift.
Right. Absolutely. So a couple other things I want to mention. Always give a shout out to Mayor O'Leary and his administration, Paul Pruneruski, and all the Board of Aldermen who are helping support the Central Business District Investment Program. This program that is being administered by the Chamber is able to put grant funds to businesses that are ready to come into downtown Waterbury. You have to be in the Central Business District, work with a property owner, bring a new business in, and apply for grant funds. So this is, you know, I hate to use the word free money, but it really is. It has to be matched by the building owner, and there's some other requirements, but this is an opportunity for us to use some of the funds that were made available to by the federal government to many of our municipalities. So it's called the Central Business District Investment Program. Please look up on our website, waterburychamber.com. If you've been thinking about opening a business in the downtown Waterbury area, or if you're a business building owner, you should know about this program. So please check that out. March 23rd, we're going to have our annual Mayor's Luncheon. It's an event where the business community gets to hear straight from the mayor of, you know, progress, economic development initiatives that have been going on within the city and what is on the agenda for 2023. So that's March 23rd. And you have to be a chamber member to go to that. So many reasons to join the chamber. I encourage you to go on waterburychamber.com. You can enroll. You can reach out to me directly. Always welcome phone calls or emails. And my email address is lward@waterburychamber.com.
All right. As always, very informative. And I know we've just scratched the surface of what the chamber is going to be doing next year. But you're always busy, always out there, always a part of the community. So
thank you.
I want to wish you a very Merry Christmas.
Same to you.
Happy and successful New Year.
Thank you, Steve.
And we will talk with you in about a month.
Thank you. Happy holidays to everyone.
Take care, Lynn. We'll take a break for the top of the hour news. And then when we get back, we'll have more Talk of the Town, including a conversation with State Representative Joe Paletta will be joining us. State Senator Eric Berthel will be joining us. And we'll also speak with Brian Sherman of the with details on the new Bank of America Homebuyer Insights Report. So stay tuned for more Talk of the Town.